Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So this is an initiative taken by us in order to promote computational knowledge among researchers and engineers. And we especially focus on those students who just started their project work or research work. And our video would definitely help them. So this video is presented by me, Shishendu Mitra, research scholar of Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. So if you have any queries, any doubts, you can write me on the given mail IDs and I'll be happy to reply to your email. So today I'm going to teach you regarding COMSOL multiphysics, what multiphysics basically is, what are the basic things of COMSOL. When you use COMSOL, you come across those things like what is step size, what is a convergence curve, what is a solver, which solver you should use. All those basic things are very much essential whenever you are using any kind of software. So those things I'll try to clear in this video. So I'm just going to show you. Just a minute. Yeah. So this is a file which I already uploaded in my YouTube channel. And that is basically on a multiphysics problem, and there was a fluid flow along with heat transfer. That means there is a pipe, the fluid is flowing from this inlet to that outlet, and the plates or the walls of the channel were at different temperatures. Say this channel was, I'll tell you, this wall was at 350 Kelvin, whereas the top one was at 293 Kelvin. So there was a temperature gradient, and because of that, during fluid flow, some sort of heat transfer also was associating with the problem. So we already solved that one. You can check this video. But here I'll tell you what multiphysics basically is. So this particular problem is a multiphysics problem. Now multi means more than one, so here we have more than one physics. The one is laminar flow, fluid flow, other is heat transfer. So these two physics, laminar flow SVF and the heat transfer HT, are coupled, and that is why those are called multiphysics. So you can see here one multiphysics written, something already came here. This means now whenever it shows, it means these two physics are already coupled. Now how did I couple it? I will show you. You can see, actually you need to see what are the equations we are solving. So in fluid flow, I will show you. Yeah, those are the equation we are solving. So this is nothing but the Navier-Stokes equation or momentum equation, and this is the continuity equation. And this equation we are solving because of fluid flow, and we have the associated boundary condition that I already told you. Some pressure condition I have put at the inlet and at the outlet also, some other pressure, and the walls are kept at no slip condition. So those are the boundary conditions which we require for solving the problem. So this laminar flow physics is well posed. Now we go to heat transfer. Now we look into the equations. So you can see those are the equations we are solving in heat transfer. So one thing you can see here, in heat transfer there is a term U, and this U comes from the velocity of the fluid, because we have taken heat transfer in fluid. So there is a fluid, and that is in flow. So that is why one velocity terms come. Now where from this U would come? That U has to come from this laminar flow physics. Whenever these things are happening, that means you have a heat transfer equation where you have a variable U that is governed by some other physics, then you have to couple those two physics, and this is what called multiphysics. Now I'll show you exactly how did I couple it. If you go here, heat transfer in fluid, it will ask for few properties, say absolute pressure and the velocity field. Now there is a drop down option. You can see there are two. One is user defined, and this absolute pressure SPF. What does it mean? It means when SPF, that means this laminar flow physics we are solving, we have a parameter called P, that is the pressure of the fluid. Another parameter U, which we are solving in laminar flow physics. So we are taking these values from this physics. So this is the place where we are coupling these two physics, and this is called multiphysics. And other things you can see, the physical properties which I gave from the material. I took some material. This is the material. I took water. You can see here. And the properties I am taking here from the material itself. So now I guess the things are clear, that you already came to know what multiphysics is. Now a few more things. When you solve these equations, there is a thing, study means there are two kinds of studies. One is static, another is time dependent. So static means you are solving a steady state problem, and the time dependent means you are solving unsteady state problem. Now whenever you are solving unsteady state, then you need to give a range. So here I was solving for 0, 0.1 to 1. What does it mean? I was solving it for 1 second, 0 to 1, and I split it into domain which is that means the step size was 0.1. that means I'm solving 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 1. But the thing is, here whenever you give any step size, that basically means COMSOL, after solving the equations, they will store the data at this very step size time. What does it mean? It means when COMSOL will simulate, it will generate some data, and for 0 second, 0.1 second, 0.2 second, 0.3 second up to 1 second, it will store the data, so that later on you can plot it and you can extract your data and you can see the simulation result. So this is the sole purpose of giving this step size, is to save the solution. But when COMSOL solves the equations, then what happens, I'll show you. If you go to the log, here in the graphics window, you can see, just a minute, I need to run it once again in order to show that. So I clicked on compute. Yeah, you can see when the solution is happening, you can see on time, step size. I'll show. Yeah, the simulation completed. Yeah, you can see there are steps 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to say, here in this particular case 17, and the time 0, 0.001, 0.002. so one thing you can see here, when it is solving for 0, this is written out again at 0.1, it is written out, then again 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like that. So this out means when we are solving for, actually when the time 0.1, 0.2 comes, it is storing the data, that means out, because I have given a step size of 0.1, that means 0.1 up to 1 second. So that is why this is showing out. And but when it is solving, it is not exactly taking delta t as 0.1, but it is taking 0.001 then 0.001. this is the step size, that means the delta t value. So based on the simulation, it takes sometimes 0.001 0.002. it solely depends on your problem and your boundary conditions. But the thing is, when the step size which you gave comes, it only stores the data. So this much is sufficient for you. One more thing I'll show you. There is a convergence plot. Now what does it plot? There is a plot of reciprocal of step size versus time step. Now what is the reciprocal of this step size? So you can see here the step size for step 1, this time step means it goes from 1 to 17 as I shown you earlier, as I have shown you earlier. From 0 up to 17, there are 17 steps in order to solve this particular problem. So for each step, what was the exact delta t or step size we can have, and if we just reciprocate it, so we know what is the reciprocal of step size, that is what we just plotted. So the reciprocal of this one versus this steps number, actually steps we have plotted, and this curve shows like this, it is decreasing. So one thing you can understand, suppose you are solving for 1 second and if your step size is very high, then you need minimum number of steps in order to complete your simulation. Here the step size was 0.001, 0.002, but it was increasing. After that step size became 0.1. So overall only 17 steps were needed, that is why it took very less amount of time in order to simulate, as you have seen here. But sometimes what happens, the step size becomes very less. Suppose I want to solve it for 10 seconds and the step size is becoming 10 to the power minus 4 or like that. So then so many number of steps the COMSOL has to perform, and then it takes a longer amount of time in order to solve it. So this convergence plot, if this value increases, that is going to tell you if the simulation would take longer time. So those are the basic things of COMSOL. And one more thing, there are options of solver. There are several types of solvers. So here you can see this is a solver configuration. If you just expand it, you will get some solver, direct solver. So there are several kinds of solver, MAMS, PARDISO, and all those solvers. What are those things? If you want to know, you can just Google it, and you will be getting the exact information. Here you can visit COMSOL website in order to know in detail things of PARDISO and MAMS, etc. One more thing I'll tell you. You can see one option came fully coupled. What does it mean? It means now these two physics are coupled. That is why the transfer of the values from this laminar flow physics is happening from this laminar flow physics to this heat transfer one. So once again I'm recapitulating what are the things I covered today. So now by the time now you know what is multiphysics, how to couple equations, how to couple multiphysics in COMSOL, what is step size, what is reciprocal of step size, what is convergence plot, what is solver, what is fully coupled. So these things you need in order to perform your simulation in COMSOL. So I guess the video would definitely help you. So if it helps, please subscribe to my channel and kindly share these videos. Thank you very much.